Thank you. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Death is never easy, but our Christian faith teaches us that death is the only beginning of eternal life that God promises to all who trust in the Lord. God's word comforts us. The scripture the family decided for today is from 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 7 through 8, where we hear these words, I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Now there is in store for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing. 101 years old. That's an amazing thing, isn't it? Lee made it look easy. In all the years that he lived and journeyed in this life, and all the ways he served our community, and all the ways that he made a difference in the lives of his family and in the hopes that they share, Lee, for lack of better words, as complicated as he is to describe, made it look very easy. I think it's interesting that when Lee came into this world, a pandemic was happening. And when he left this life, another one was happening as well. I don't think you can get anywhere close to 101 years old without those three elements that the Apostle Paul made, where he says, I have fought the good fight. I have run the race. I have completed that race. And I have kept the faith. Now, I have orders, direct orders. Lee wrote this down and the family shared it with me. Whatever you do at the cemetery or whatever service it is, it needs to be sweet and short. And so that's kind of complicated for a pastor that's got a big, long-winded voice like me. So I'm probably going to stop right there because the obituary shares his story and the challenges that he faced in the army and the challenges he faced in life and the complications that he faced along the way. But he fought the good fight. He ran the race. And he kept the faith through it all. And so I'm going to stop right there because I'm a believer in resurrection, and I imagine Lee would probably resurrect right now and say, Pastor, get your head together and get done.
Grandpa had many life experiences, many I would never want to personally experience. One thing I do know, he loved his family dearly. And I'd have to say, he was a one-of-a-kind grandpa. He never wanted anyone to go without. He was always there to cheer me on, whether it was telling him, Grandpa, I'm going back to school again, or told him, I got a new job, even though it's the third time in 7 years. He'd say, good job. I know you can do it, or do you need anything? Grandpa was a great listener. He listened with the intent to understand rather than listening to determine a response. Many times he'd just answer with a shake of the head. Other times he knew you needed his advice. I don't know a better businessman. He knew what it took to succeed, and I can only hope I could be half the person he was. So Grandpa, I love you and will forever have a piece of me missing without you here. I just hope you and Grandma are taking Kinsley to breakfast like you always did with us. And please spoil her in heaven like you did us here on earth.
Let us pray. Dear Lord, we thank you that you are our refuge and our strength and that you are ever close to those that mourn. We pray that you will give us the help and wisdom that we need at this time as we face the task of living without our loved one. We pray that you will be a special comfort to uplift in the care for all those who feel this great loss this day and in the days to come. Help us to remember that although we are separated for a small amount of time, We will rejoice one day for all eternity as we stand together in your presence and those who have journeyed on. And so in the sure and the certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord, we commit our brother in faith, Lee E. Zink. We commit his remains to their final resting place, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And with the promise of your word, Lord, we will never be alone. And together we praise you and thank you for the comfort we receive now. As you look graciously upon those who are in sorrow and those that mourn, that they will cast all their cares on you and they may know the consolation of your love. And through Jesus Christ, our Lord, we pray, as in the same way you teach us how to pray through Jesus by saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Deliver us. Well, y'all threw me off on that one. Lee's got me going. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. I'm going to say, Lee, stop that. And now, may the Lord bless you and bring you peace. May we be comforted as the military honors now proceed.